Dear crypto community, welcome back to Cryptonites, special edition, the Battle of the Blockchains, episode 3, and today we're going to cover Polkadot. Should I buy, hold, and earn interest on DOT? How is it relative to Ethereum, so that we have a very objective point of view, because these episodes favor sustainable wealth over pump and dump schemes, intelligent investment decisions over pure speculation and gambling. But before we kick off, please understand that you should not see this as investment advice. You should trust yourself 100% and do your own research. This video is only for edutainment purposes. All right, so without further ado, Polkadot and the DOT token. Here we go. The core differences, and if you missed episode 1, click above, you can get access to all this information. Polkadot is a layer 0, meaning that it is the core level where you can build blockchains on top of it. While Ethereum, you build applications or decentralized applications, so Ethereum is a layer 1. So why compare Polkadot and Ethereum? Well, first and foremost, Ethereum is the mother of all blockchains with regards to creating DAPPs, decentralized applications. But on top of that, the creator of Polkadot, Gavin Wood, was actually a part of the Ethereum core engineering team. So he saw inside how everything works. And speaking of works, Ethereum is still a proof of work blockchain, which requires GPU, hardware, etc. to maintain its security, while Polkadot is a nominated proof of stake. So less energy heavy and more eco-friendly in that sense. And as you all may know, Ethereum is actually transitioning to ETH 2.0, which is also a proof of stake chain.
First off, it's really important to understand why Ethereum has almost a 20x market cap relative to Polkadot. Well, the first question is adoption and how much usage there is on chain. So let's kick off by looking at the decentralized applications that are being built on Ethereum, because that's really what shows adoption. Today's resource we're going to use is DApp Radar, which is one of the best resources. And as you can see here, guys, OpenSea, the biggest NFT platform in the world, of course, is on Ethereum. It's also one of the biggest gas guzzlers with all the transactions. And you can see while looking on a 30-day average, right, we have over 350,000 users with $2.3 billion of activity, which is critical, right? Because that's the revenue, that's how it's paying out the miners, it's creating a healthy ecosystem. But you also have Uniswap V2 and V3 that is being used again on Ethereum, right? And if you take V2, V3, look at this, guys. You have $71 billion plus $80 billion. That's $150 billion of activity in the past 30 days alone on Ethereum, right? And then you have MetaMask Swap, you have 1inch that's providing $8 billion of volume, you have Sushi, and if we scroll down, you can see other high quality decentralized applications on its layer one, right? You can see Curve down here, Convex, Sandbox, etc., etc. So really here, Ethereum has proven that it has real use cases. And on top of these, like DApps, we got to remember those are not the only use cases of Ethereum. One critical one are the actual tokens that are being built as an application on top of Ethereum. Have a look at these tokens, guys. So we have Tether here with, in 24 hours, $60 billion of volume. You can look at the amount of holders on chain market cap. But another use case that has held its time is USD coin, for instance, guys. You know that it's a regulated stable coin. And again, look at the activity that we have here. We have all the wraps from other chains that need the Ethereum liquidity, and the list goes on and on and on. So just to summarize what we need to look for to really justify Ethereum's market cap currently as the mother boat, as the absolute queen of all layer one protocols, is by looking at the dApps that are being built, by looking at the tokens and use cases as we saw just here. But on top of that, we can see that there are also a huge use case for non-fungible tokens, the NFTs, with ERC-721, ERC-1155. So those three components are critical to understand why Ethereum is the leader at the moment. Now let's quantify this a little bit more with some stats on DeFi Llama that will hopefully build a clear picture. By the way, this is absolutely beautiful to see Bitcoin coming back and breaking the $46,000 previous resistance. But anyways, guys, let's have a look at Ethereum here. So you can see that the market cap is $400 billion, while Polkadot is $25 billion. So there is a difference in roughly 15x. So if Polkadot manages to grow as big as Ethereum in the future, you can assume that just based on the market cap of today, Polkadot would at least 10x from now, right? Obviously that we can never predict the future and we never know, but it's just to keep this into consideration, because again, this show is really to look at it from the investment perspective, right? Not just to compare which chain has accomplished more, because it's obvious right now when it comes to adoption that in round one, Ethereum knocks out Polkadot in terms of adoption without a single ounce of a doubt. Now, let's further quantify this, guys, by looking at these metrics on DeFi Llama. So you can see here that Ethereum has $124.6 billion in TVL. And you can see that it's more than half of the market is on Ethereum. Last year was even crazier, right? Because now we can see Terra has gone through huge growth. And then there are other chains that are coming into the play. But really, like when it comes to TVL, Ethereum, again, is absolutely destroying all the others. And there are lots of layer two solutions, which we covered in the first video, if you want to have a look, that are helping Ethereum grow in that sense. Now, when we look at Polkadot, guys, remember, Polkadot is a layer zero. So we're not looking at dApps, but we're looking at actual blockchains. So let's click on Polkadot here, and as you can see here, Polkadot currently has only $1.68 billion, so that's quite low in terms of TVL. However, the numbers are growing exponentially, right? Because Polkadot has been focusing on scalability and security as the prime features and is taking its time with the Kusama protocol to be able to build in a confident, secure, but scalable way. But here you can see, here are some of the main applications on the dot chain as of today. We have Parallel, we have A-Star, we have Moonbeam, which is a critical component for Polkadot, and we'll explain why. But if we further look on the Polkadot subscan website, which is the best area to get all chain statistics, and we click on Parachain, you can see these are the projects that are building on top of the Polkadot layer zero infrastructure, right? So we have some other names like Akala, which we didn't see in the previous page. We have Composable Finance. We have Hydra DX, Centrifuge, Affinity, which is the engine program. So you guys can see here clearly that Polkadot does have some interesting projects building on top of it. Okay, guys, so let's simplify this terminology. We talked about layer zeros having blockchains on top. The Polkadot ecosystem, its layer zero is called the relay chain. And then on top of the relay chain, we have what we call number one, a parachain, number two, a parathread. A parachain is essentially voted by the community through an auction where every community member needs to stake their DOT tokens for the course of 24 months, meaning that every single time a project wins a parachain slot, all those tokens are gone from circulating supply, creating scarcity, which, to be very honest, is a lot more advanced than the Ethereum tokenomics or utilities. So definitely on the tokenomics and use case of the tokens, Polkadot knocks out Ethereum by a far fetch, and the governance system, which involves the community plus the people at Parity, Web3, and all the people involved around is a lot more advanced than Ethereum as well. Although some people may say there are more validators on the Ethereum side, so it's more decentralized, but as in pure token utilities, the DOT is a lot more advanced than ETH. And a ParaThread is also using tokens, so it's more like a lease. So to keep it very simple, right? A parachain is kind of like you find the house of your dreams. That house has 4 to 5 different rooms. Each one has its different use case, and you buy that house, you live in it, you use it every single day. A ParaThread are for those who do not go through these auctions, but want to rent or lease. Maybe they'll just rent one room, or maybe they'll just rent a small apartment, but they do not need all the functionalities. Now here, once again, as you can see on the screen, we have 54.2% of all DOT staked at the moment, which is quite good, it's going up. The inflation rate, so still the token supply is not out there, 7%, which is relatively good. We have close to 1 million holders. It's good to see that it's not just whales, but actual individuals like us. So these numbers are the general statistics, but even more interesting than these numbers is if we move on to staking rewards. This is critical information, guys, because Ethereum at the moment still hasn't announced a clear date or timeline on the launch of ETH 2.0. And because of those reasons where there's a lack of clarity, you can see that Ethereum here only has 7.9% of all tokens staked. When you compare it with Polkadot, as we just saw, this is actually inaccurate. The live data is saying 54%, but it's pretty much the same, right? You see all the amount of tokens staked. Again, in terms of the tokenomics, Polkadot wins by a far stretch. Now, something that's also very interesting is that Polkadot offers way better yields than ETH 2.0. So when you see here, roughly 4 to 5% for ETH, Polkadot is offering 14% in terms of yield on the proof of stake chain, which is, once again, that's almost triple the amount of Ethereum. So staking amounts, staking returns and interest, again, two at least good punches and kicks on Ethereum in that sense. And just to solidify that, in terms of the actual tokenomics, in terms of setting up a structure that really depends on DOT and creating an ecosystem around this, without a doubt, Polkadot is the winner. On top of the yields and interest being higher on Polkadot relative to Ethereum, because of the uncertainty on the transition from ETH to ETH 2.0, we can see here that when you stake ETH on, for example, Lido.fi, you don't know when you can get your tokens back. While with Polkadot, if you use the Polkadot JS extension wallet, then you can redeem them every 28 days. So if you actually try to unbond your tokens today, in 28 days, you'll get them all back. So that's also something to take into consideration. Because once again, Ethereum has so many DApps applications built on top of it that it's really hard to compare at this point. And that will be something we need to look at in the future. With regards to gas fees, as you guys know, Ethereum goes anywhere from $10 to over $100, which we saw in Q4 last year, while Polkadot ranges in the cents. It's under a dollar. An average somewhere between 10 to 20 cents per transaction. So without a doubt, but once again, this is the thing we need to monitor, guys, because we really need to know, is Polkadot gonna be able to sustain the speed and gas fees when it gets more congested, when it gets more and more parachains or parathreads built on top? That is the ultimate question.
Investor Summary Report brought to you by Borgi. So let's sum it up with three T's: the technology, the token, but also the traction. So number one, Borgi, who wins the technological race? Well, Borgi believes that because Polkadot is a layer zero and Ethereum is a layer one, plus Polkadot has 1,000 transactions per second, plus 200 to 300 transactions per second just for one of its parachains, which is already 10 times what Ethereum can do on the main chain, Polkadot. On top of that, we have the transaction costs, which are much lower than Ethereum by 1 to 100th. I think it's easy to say that Polkadot has better technology as of today. Now, what if ETH 2.0 comes out? This could be a completely different story, but one round for Polkadot. Number two, the traction. Without a single doubt, this is where Ethereum wins by a huge knockout in terms of apps that are built on top of it, the TVL, the transactions every day. It's just mind-blowing everything that is built on top of Ethereum. So round two for Ethereum. All right, so number three, let's have a look at the tokens. With ETH, and besides for gas fees and some basic governance, ETH doesn't really have a strong use case, right? It's just all the economy and the technology that's being built on top of it. But with DOT, you have very specific use cases. So for parachain auctions, the projects need to convince the community to stake the DOT for 2 years. For parathreads, these projects need to get a lease on DOT. So on top of all the transactional history and the gas fees, these are additional use cases that DOT does to get validators, delegators, nominators, community members, projects, all to be included and need DOT. And of course, on-chain statistics really prove that DOT is more advanced than Ethereum just based on the amount that's staked. So hope you guys enjoyed that. Don't forget to download the SwissBorg Wealth app so that you can buy ETH and or DOT at the best rates through 5 exchanges in your currency of choice from bank. And then on top of that, you can stake ETH. But on top of that, we're going to be releasing Polkadot Proof of Stake yield in the months to come. So stay tuned. And see you next week, premiering at a PC near you, 8 o'clock GMT. Next week, guys.